I snapped this on a pleasant evening on my mobile. Now I'm gonna try to give more light with some direction with the free apps Snapseed and Lightroom. First, after importing to Snapseed, I'm gonna increase the highlights a bit to make the sky more brighter. Also the shadows for more details in the foreground. Next for some darkening and selective brightening to give direction to the light with the vintage filter and masking. With the default values and preset 12, I'm gonna apply the vintage filter. Then with masking, tapping on the stacks icon here, view edits, vintage filter and the brush. With the vintage effect enabled with the brush opaqueness at 0, I'm gonna brush out the effect selectively to brighten parts of the image. Here you can see the light coming from the right, so making the light fall here on the foreground on the left and also creating some dark shadows on the right. Toggle the eye icon to see where the effect is removed. Now tuning the curves to make the highlights, the sky here more brighter. Next with the brush tool and its value set at 5 for some dodging. Brushing on these parts to give more light. Also some darkening here in the shadows with the value at -5. Now for some selective editing with selective filters. First one on the blue sky to make it a bit more darker and also recovering the color by increasing the saturation. More saturation on the trees here. Popping the grass here on the foreground, more brightness, contrast and color. Also one around here. Next to brighten the light source, I'm gonna use curves. Dragging the whole curve here towards left, lifting the blacks and brightening the pixels across the board. Now with masking, applying it on the light source. also just on the trees around to give some sunlit haze. After these edits in Snapseed, exporting these to the Lightroom app to add color to the image. Here in Lightroom, going directly to the HSL sliders in the color menu mix. For more color to the greens, moving the hues just a little towards aqua. Also more saturation. And the blues a little towards aqua, also darkening it a bit by reducing the luminance values. Now in the split tone in the effects menu, I'm gonna apply some orangish tint to the highlights. We'll stop around here. Also blues to the shadows to give some color contrast. Coming back to the color menu mix, trying to add more color to the yellows. Reducing the saturation of the path by tuning the oranges. Now to the curves in the light menu, to make the image more warmer, dragging the blue curve just a bit towards right, which adds yellow to the overall image. Tuning the contrast with the RGB curve. Finally, adding some vibrance. The final result. Thanks for watching.